Welcome back. We are at Spectra Saloon in Bugolobi. We're having such a marvelous conversation. I've got the fantastic, phenomenal ladies from Miss Curvy Pageant 2019. I also have phenomenal comedian Dolly Wondo, who is trying to be stunned by all the ladies on this panel. My name is Maritza, and we're getting into the conversation. Now, before we went for a break, I wanted us to consider the children we're raising. Who of us has kids? I know, Mariam, you have a child. And you're at now, Steven.
I don't know how to define it. I don't know how to define it. Is it fortunate or unfortunate?
Do you have a girl? You have a girl.
Yes, Hailey.
It's very. Oh my God, the blessings. You're not even ready.
Uh-huh. Huh?
And do you have a mother? You're also a mother. So we have parents.
Yeah.
Okay? So as we live our lives, we need to keep, like, we're very conscious about the kind of path we're setting for the kids and the kind of world we want to create for them. Because we grow up in a world, if there's things we don't like, we hope to change those things. So something like body weight, something like body shapes and body types, and, you know, even things like money. Why is it that we put so much emphasis on this is the way this is supposed to look? And if you do not have a curve on this part of your body, you are incorrect. So think, why do we focus on things like that, and how can we change that? Let's start with the mothers even. Brenda, let's actually start with you. How do we change, you know, the perception of weight is, you know, this is the weight, this is how things are supposed to be. How do we change that? How do we create a world where all body types are accepted, all body shapes are accepted, all kinds of people are accepted?
I just don't think it's all right for someone to say this is the body shape, this is the body size.
Mm.
I think what I think is that we are supposed to embrace each other the way we are.
Yeah.
We're not supposed to be picky, like, this person is supposed to have curves, this girl is supposed to have hips for me to love her, or she's supposed to be slim.
Thank you.
To my side of view, I think it is not right at all. And as Dolly Wondo was saying, that when you're 8 size and then you get it to the 9 size, he won't like you. That is not right.
Mm.
I think When you fall in love with someone, Dolly Wondo, this comes to you. When you fall in love with someone, you're supposed to love that inner person, not the outer part of it. You're not supposed to look at the person because Brenda, she has a hip, see, like, she doesn't have the hips anymore, then I don't love her anymore.
Mm.
I just don't think that is right at all.
Mm.
You see, the whole point, the beauty. I'm already, the campaign, I started it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you. Because you see,
when they bring these young ones, I'm a kindergarten teacher.
Mm.
So basically, when they bring these young ones, I'm putting out there something beautiful.
Yeah.
The mindset. We create ourselves into these young ones. So what I want to see tomorrow, I'm already starting on it. I'm really empowering these young ones with confidence.
Yeah.
When you come at our school, hey, the kids are so confident.
Mm.
Very, because it is really important for you to feel comfortable within your own skin.
Yeah.
What is disturbing, Dolly Wondo, is one thing. When he was growing up, he wasn't taught to appreciate people the way they are.
Mm.
So I think the only thing we can do for the coming generation is to teach them from down, because this is the generation coming up.
Yeah.
So if we teach this generation coming up that this is a person that you should love. This is how a woman is meant to be. This generation of Dolly Wondo is going to expire. The new generation is coming, and people are going to have that mindset in them, and it's going to be very clean. And you're not going to be hustling with people that you have to explain this. You're not going to be having this discrimination among women.
Yeah.
That if even women are going to start feeling inferior, you get. So if we come up with this generation knowing the right way to behave, I think that's the only thing disturbing Dolly Wondo. If Dolly Wondo was told from day one when he was still young, he would have been appreciating the people you are with.
You know, I'm not good at explaining. However, giving examples is the best thing I can always explain myself.
And you keep going to a car. No,
I'm not going there.
Let me tell you.
No, because you guys were talking about cars.
Don't got nothing on the board. We're talking about cars in regard to money.
Okay.
Right? In regard to money.
And it's the same direction I took, because you guys started it. Now, this is what I would advise. First and foremost, we have to learn to deal with human nature.
Yeah.
Yeah. in life, at a certain point, you love something so much. You'll buy a dress, you love it so much, and maybe after a year, you feel like you're fed up of the dress. And somebody else will take it as something very precious.
Yeah.
You get me? You can pass it on to your sister or your friend, and they'll find it very fit for them. You get me? Now, with the next generation, I think all we have to, what I think should be done, is the fact that, one, they should be taught about changes. They should learn about changes. Because the biggest challenge I'm seeing that women usually use to defend themselves of the size is change.
Why do women
when I grow up, I get big. When I give birth, I don't go back to shape. When I take contraceptives, I don't do this.
The real question here, and the real question I want us to tackle, is why do we need to defend our size? Why do we need to defend our size? That's why I keep bringing up.
Okay,
there's
now,
no such thing as this is the correct
you
size.
Don't,
this is
you
the correct
actually
shape.
Don't need to defend your size if your partner found the right person for them.
Does that mean if say
if I come for your size and you get to her size, I'm going to have an issue.
But the person inside has not changed. So why is there an issue?
That's where you go back with the specs. If the camera on my phone is 8 pixels and it can't
stop it. Okay. I think do you know that I can influence you to love my size, however much you don't love my size.
Then you better do that.
Do you know
I think
that
it's
I can
better
influence
that
you?
You can. I know
so
you can.
So this thing comes in that if you come and let me down with my size and challenge me, I'm going to challenge you back that I love my size. Do you know you're going to get inspired of the way I love myself?
Then I think it's best if you do that. Otherwise, I talk about your size.
Thank you, Donnie.
I talk about your size.
Thank you. Thank you. Now, how are we supposed to love our size when the conversations, not just in the media, but even with advertising, even in schools, even like conversations that children here overhear people having, is that woman lost her shape, she's now fat. How are we supposed to love ourselves when confidence is affected? Why? Because you lost your shape. Bullying is on the rise because you lost your shape. But this
Marita,
is the shape God gave.
Marita, do you realize that your dress code can also make your body come out well or bad?
That's another conversation.
No. First answer
some
me.
People don't
First
know.
Answer me that
I do realize that.
Yes. Now, you'll find that...
So you just hate the
listen,
clothes.
You'll find... No. I'm getting there. Uh-huh. You find that you are in your kind of size. Uh-huh. You're putting on skimpy things. Uh-huh. You're looking nice. Uh-huh. You get to her shape where skimpy things are not looking good on you, and you still put them on. So before,
in case you
before
didn't know,
you realize,
this curvy over here is flouncing and dripping in her little dress.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so she's showing thigh. Are you offended by thigh?
No. Sometimes there are those. There comes a point
where they are dressed inappropriately. When
let's say your calf does not look nice being out.
Yeah. Now, do you know why that?
When
is?
You have stretch marks everywhere and you're exposing them.
Dolly Wondo, that's why. Do you know why that is, Dolly Wondo? Because you think it's wrong.
Dolly Wondo, let me tell you one thing.
Because you think it's wrong.
There is
it is a size, but it doesn't look good. This is not a painting.
Now, Dolly Wondo, let me ask you a question. Yes. Why do you say? Why do you keep going back to it doesn't look good? Actually, not even a question. This is an answer. You keep going back to it doesn't look good because in your mind,
whatever
already,
I'm saying is
no,
in my
in your mind
is my opinion.
Already, exactly, it's your opinion.
Yeah. So in my opinion,
you have already decided that too big size. There's a size that is not appropriate for you.
Exactly. For me, there is a size that is not.
But what you're saying is,
we are not.
No, I've said there is a size.
Which size?
Which size? Yeah, it is.
Us. Have you seen him? Yeah, like, us. Us. So my question, what I'm saying is that because you have said there's a size that's not appropriate for you, you're declaring it like it's a wrong size. And that is the problem. People take their personal preferences. People take their personal preferences and impose them on cultures and impose them on people and decide, because I don't like this, it is wrong. I want to hear from Belinda. You were going to say something.
Yeah, I wanted to tell him, you don't like the stretch marks. You don't like the big thighs. But then, hey, I won't wake up one day when I look like Beyonce. I'm going to love myself.
embrace me. I don't care what the public will say, because it's from self-love that male children are going to love from their mommy.
Yeah. Mm?
Because if I don't love myself and I keep hiding myself, my child will be affected too. So it's from us that the young generation will pick. So we won't wake up and be anything. You just have to embrace what you have, what you are. Then, you see what?
So long as you look
I guess
at yourself,
if you woke up one day and you don't like your size, I'm saying, if you woke up one day and you don't love the size you are in right now, for instance, you're going to work it out. But then if you go to that size, because you're also not, you're not going to wake up in a night. Okay, it's not going to be an overnight that you're going to wake up from 70 to 90 kgs. You get me? This is something that comes gradually. So if you're seeing it and you let it go to that extent, it means that is one what you find comfortable with. However, you should also think of me as well.
Your mindset has to adjust. What you were taught as a child, you have to unlearn. Yes. Certain shapes and sizes are not wrong. So you can't say that this woman deserves less respect because she doesn't go to the gym, and this woman deserves more respect. Oh my God, she does squats. No. Do you know plus size women do squats better than most skinny girls?
I've not seen
any. How do you think their booties get so boom? Like, they have like the most upright booties. Some of us, our booties slept. Because we're not working out, right? So we can't still be in a society where we are okay with judging a book by its cover. If I go for a job interview, Dolly Vondo is interviewing me for his next skit. I want to be in the skit. I should not be judged because I am larger than Dolly Vondo likes. Does that make sense? So when you put that mindset out there and you put your child in that environment, what do you expect?
That's why what I said in the first place.
You'll
that
take her to the gym.
No. that men should be ready, as in men should look out for the sizes they want. You get me?
But the size will change.
When the size changes, it's a problem if you don't work on the size to the size I got you with.
So you also change. Have you realized that you
I
also
like,
change?
I feel like we are but reaching, me, we are I, reaching I, a dead
me,
end. Me, now,
me I try to work out on myself. Because
place.
Me...
We are at the same place. Aha, I have a question for you. Before you were Dolly Vondo, Camp Comedy, what was your kilos?
I guess I had about 50 something.
And 50 now? Something.
50
and
so, 52.
When the money checked in, when the money checked in, even the woman checked in, you're feeding right, your skin is even glowing, you're eating properly. What weight are you today, Dolly Vondo?
Recently, I measured when I was 85.
She went there.
Listen.
Let's take a quick break. We're watching Saloon Talk. My name is Maritza. We're here with the Miss Curvy contest, Miss Curvy winners. We're also here with Dolly Vondo, and we're getting in on the conversation about women, about size, and about rights. You can be part of this conversation on our Facebook and our Twitter. We are at Spectra Saloon. We'll be right back.